It is a beautiful day for some DSA, and welcome back to the Cozy Club, my friends. My name is Cozy Gamer, and it has been exactly 1 week since the Forbidden Depths has launched in Disney Sorcerer's Arena. For today's video, we're going to be going over all of the leaderships in the game. Previously, leaderships were not that important because PvE content could be cleared with ease in PvP. You were only using one character. However, with raids now more than ever, leadership abilities are so imperative to make the best possible teams and do the most damage for your club on the raid. So for today's video, we're going to be looking at all the leaderships in the game, starting with the highlighted leaderships and looking at some of the better ones for the Forbidden Depths so that you guys can look at your roster and pair and match some great teams to go together. When you're going into a phase, you want to make sure you've got a leadership ability, or else you're kind of wasting the potential of a team and you're not getting all the bonuses that you can get. Now is a great time to say, if you have not joined the Cozy Twitch family, you have missed out on 2 full streamings of the Heroic Raid. The first one took 4 hours. We did a huge stream, and the second one took about 2.5 hours. I've done them from start to finish, phase 1 to phase 4. We try out a load of different characters, different teams, to best find the best strategies to get the most damage out of every single character. So if you guys haven't already, check the description down below, send a follow, subscribe to the Twitch channel, and let's go ahead and start today's video. So Cozy Club, this is going to kick off our series for the roles of the raid. We're going to be talking about all the different roles and how effective they can be within the Forbidden Depths. Today, we're going to be talking about the leaders or the leadership abilities within the raid. Next time, we've got cleansers, we have tanks, we have healers, we've got heavy hitters. We've got a lot of videos coming to the Cozy Club, guys. I'm excited. Let's break down and start today's video. So let's kick off today's video with our first leadership ability, starting out with Ana. Now, Ana is a great leader to have both in phase 2 and phase 3 because of the healing that she does once a teammate has fallen below 60% health. They're going to gain defense up, health over time, and more max health, in addition gaining more helpful effects as well. So if you're running Ana leadership with the Frozen squad, which you definitely should, you're gonna have Elsa be gaining 30% more speed turn meter whenever her health goes below 60%. Also, you're gonna get 10% more health for each Frozen teammate. And then lastly, on the battle start, you guys know this, Kristoff is going to get 20% more speed meter per Frozen teammate, which is actually very viable in phase 2 because he's going to get his taunt and his harmful immunity out before the eels can get the charm or any other effects out on the field. So it's actually going to be really helpful to have about 4 Frozen members in the squad in general so that you get that taunt, you get that helpful effect, and you get the guaranteed crit out and start rolling the damage. Now, one quick note to know, everybody, is we're gonna be looking at the leaderships at max potential. I realize a lot of these are gonna have some percentage numbers that are off, but for the most part, the leadership ability doesn't change as a whole outside of like Judy Hopps and Mr. Incredible, which we'll talk about those and what levels you need to take those to. Just wanted to let you guys know that your percent numbers might be a little bit different, but not too drastic. Next up on the list, we have Ariel. Now, for the pay-to-play members, you're gonna wanna make sure you use her with Triton under a Triton lead, which we'll get to. But for free to play, mid game, and anyone without King Triton, Ariel is going to have a great lead for the raid, and you're going to get a flat health percent bonus to all of your characters. That's going to work great within phase 3. Most likely, you can pair up with Moana and some of the old school Oceanic crew. That way, you're getting more health to go against Ursula, and as well as getting that healing that's going to cleanse the poisoning that Ariel offers. So she's going to be great to pair up with Prince Eric. Go into phase 3 if you don't have King Triton, or throw into phase 4, and you're looking at a very solid lead for raids. All right, so we've got another great leadership ability in Bo Peep. It's quite simple, not very long. All teammates are going to gain 12% offense. And if they're a Toy Story member, they're going to get 24% offense, my friends. If you have an Emperor Zerg, you definitely want to utilize him within a Bo Peep-led team. I run Toy Story within phase 2 and phase 3 to get that healing triggering from Woody and more damage potential altogether. But I love Bo Peep and what she can do, just amping up all of the characters around her. And if you don't have Toy Story and your Bo Peep's very low, doesn't matter. Just throw in her leadership, put her in a squatter, have her die off, but still give that bonus offense. She's great for throwaway phases like phase 4, or if you want to use her in phase 2 again, she works phenomenally there. Next, we've got the leader of the Duck faction in the Sensational 6, or should I say Sensational 3 at the moment, but this guy is going to be giving up to 22% offense to all Sensational 6 and all Duck teammates. In addition, every single time a Duck teammate gets attacked, they have a 10% chance to counter, which is going to stack with Daisy and Donald's kit altogether. If you haven't, go ahead and check the video up above about the great synergy between Daisy and Donald. But actually, Donald is a great lead to have. I find him best working in phase 1 and 2. Pairing him up with the Ducks, obviously Goofy's going to be great for cleansing. I know not a lot of people have him right now, but keep your eyes when he comes back because Donald does some phenomenal things. And my personal guess is when we get the rest of the Sensational 6, you're going to see a very solid raid squad. All right, Cozy Club, we've been here before. You already know that Hiro Hamada has the best PvP lead possible within the game. And guess what? That's going to translate beautifully over to the Forbidden Depths. Hiro Hamada's got a great lead, giving 10% extra speed for both Tech and Big Hero 6 teammates, and you can never go wrong with more speed as they're going to get more and more attacks on the field. So he's great to use with the rest of the Big Hero 6 in phase 4. Also, I've got a great team that I've been testing out on phase 1 that has the possibility, and it's free to play friendly, but has the possibility to do some massive damage against Glut the Shark, which is probably the phase that most people are currently struggling with. Hero's gonna be a great plugin for just about any phase in just about any team. All right, now here we have a lead that I've mentioned in a lot of my roster reviews, which speaking of, I'm gonna pick a random comment down below and give you a free roster review. But within my roster reviews, I talk about Judy Hopps and just getting her to an unlockable level that you can use this powerful lead both in Club Conquest and in Arena and now within the raids. What you're gonna get out of here is a downtown hero that is gonna be giving 12% dodge chance to other downtown heroes. On teammates receiving a harmful effect, if they are a downtown hero, she's also going to have a 20% chance to perform a spinning kick, which is going to be doing a little bit of extra damage, which will rack up over time, and it has a chance to stun the enemy. Now, keep in mind, the spinning kick is on the upgrade of the ability. However, once you really start getting this going, this is a great leadership to upgrade, and Judy Hopps is looking like a very solid tier 8 character. All right, Cozy Club, we have arrived. Here is the best leader within the raids. There's no question about it. Hiro Hamada, great lead altogether and can fit in more teams. However, when it comes down to the pay-to-play method, the beast from the towers, you have King Triton, and he is ready to take on Ursula. All right, now looking at the King of the Sea, he usually gives 10%, but up to 15% offense to all of his teammates. In addition, within raids, all Little Mermaid characters will be gaining an additional 10% offense. And every single time somebody is healed within the raids, they'll be gaining 10% speed turn meter. Now, this is how you get those amazing damage screenshots that you've been seeing and some powerful damage in phase 4. Really, any phase, you're going to love the Little Mermaid. They're going to do their job. Their trio is an amazing faction to use. So altogether, you're going to be seeing loads of speed meter to your team and definitely the best within a certain faction lead in the game. All right, we've landed on another oceanic leader. There's a lot of them in the game, and Maui is great because he works with just about anyone. Now, he's a little bit hard to unlock. However, Maui will be giving a shield to all of his teammates, and they will be giving a 50% more shield for oceanic teammates. Now, if Moana's a teammate, she's going to get defense up and haste for 2 turns at the start of the battle. So I usually save mine for phase 3 to get the most damage out of there. Great leader within the raid to give you a little bit of extra health so that you can do a little bit of extra damage. Solid character altogether. Pocahontas. Now you're looking at a character that was pretty much all but worthless before raids, and now she's definitely making her way up the charts. Now, she's not going to be elite. She still dies very easily, but Pocahontas does the 2 things that you're looking for within the raid, so she definitely deserves a roster spot. She can cleanse and she can heal, and she can give some great buffs to some of her other teammates. Now, looking at her leadership altogether, you're going to be having offense teammates gain 12% bonus offense. This will be once it's upgraded, but up to 12%. Defense will be getting up to 12% bonus defense, and then heroes who are support teammates will be gaining 6% recovery and potency. Now you want to make sure you pair her up with other heroes, not villains. She's only going to affect heroes, but she can work with a multitude of teams and one of the few AoE cleansers. So Pocahontas is a great lead for a plethora of plug and play teams. We've got another very solid leader for PvP, Shan Yu, but guys, guess what? He's going to also be great to use within the Forbidden Depths. Mainly because of that speed, you're not going to see much of that offense mechanic work here, as you're not going to be killing really any enemies, I guess, unless you go into the next phase. But the speed boost altogether is going to buff up the Kingdom faction, allowing for more turns, more damage, and overall viability within the raid. Now, I like the Kingdom team right now within phase 1 and phase 3. Even phase 4 can utilize the Kingdom team. I don't think I need to say more. 12% flat is going to be a great speed bonus for everybody. Kingdom can do some work. Genie's a great cleanser who can really stack up the damage, put offense down. His basic is great and a hero I recommend to most people. And the last character we're going to take an in-depth look into their leadership ability is Mr. Incredible. Now, I didn't even know, to be honest, before raids started, I didn't know that this was within his leadership, but it's perfect for phase 2 and phase 3 within the raid. Even phase 1, it can do a lot. However, you want to save dash for phase 2, as we've talked about on previous videos. So all teammates are going to gain 4% bonus tenacity. If they're an incredible hero, they're going to instead gain 16% bonus tenacity. And this is where it gets really good. At level 2, you've got to upgrade it one time, but an incredible hero, anytime they get with a harmful effect, they're going to have a 50% chance to heal. Now, why is healing important? We've talked about it. The poison mechanic starts to really lower the health on your characters altogether. So each time they're getting these harmful effects, which, spoiler alert, happens a lot within the raid, they'll be healing and cleansing that poison. I like to stick on it with the frozen, and if you'd like to really get the most maximization out of your squads, stick dash with the Incredibles if you've got them leveled up, and you can really do some damage. All right, now let's lastly look at all of the leadership abilities outside of Simba and Lotso that are Club Conquest focused. Here's a quick look at all the abilities within the game. You're going to start here with Ana, like we've talked about, Ariel, Bo Peep, Donald Duck. You've got Dr. Facilier, which if he's with other downtown villains, he can get some nice potency and you can really drain some turn meter with the Doctor. Elastigirl, I do like her lead a ton. However, a little bit better for PvP, where you're going to want to use Mr. Incredible for within the raids. You've got Gizmo Duck, who if there wasn't so much focus against shields, I think he would have a lot better shot in his leadership. But for the betas, I don't recommend using them for his specific lead, as Hiro Hamada is going to be the better tech lead. But you get some nice shield and nice critical hits if you want to go ahead and stack up some damage. Hopper will be gaining tenacity for the wilds. However, wilds are somewhat irrelevant right now, so skip Hopper. Now here's part 2. I'll be putting all these graphics within my Cozy Club Discord. Again, you can find that in the description below. But all these leaderships right here, we have already talked about some great leads within part 2. And lastly, part 3, we've got Shan Yu, which we just chatted about. You've got Syndrome, who's going to make all villains receive a bonus chance to deal a critical hit, which can be nice to stack up some damage. So if you need to use him in some of the later phases, go ahead, strap up a team together and put them with Syndrome. And then lastly, you've got Ursula. Can't be used yet. Will be amazing once she can be used. Obviously, you're going to get some really heavy damage out of oceanic villains and teammates in general. And then you have Woody. Now, Woody actually has a very good lead to pair up with the other Toy Story characters. But if you do have Bo Peep, she has the much better lead for the raid specifically. Unless you're in a certain phase like phase 1, you're going to want that extra tenacity. But outside of that, I would stick with Bo. And Cozy Club, hopefully you enjoyed today's video. That is all the leaderships within the game and definitely the ones you want to hyper focus on for the Forbidden Depths. They're definitely proving to be a challenge, but we together as the Cozy Club are making our way, finding out the best team and strategies, and we have a lot more videos. Hopefully you guys enjoyed roles of the raids. We're starting out with the leaders. We're going to be making our way through cleansers and all together harmful effect users. We've got a ton to work through. We've got the best teams coming. We've got a November tier list. Some amazing stuff coming to the Cozy Club, my friends. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video on your way out. Until next time, my friends, stay cozy.
Davey's locked and freaking loaded, dude. They would both go off of stack. Big hit here. Come on, Davey. 24K. 7K from the boys. from the boys out back. All right, he's going after Merlin now. That's fine. Go, take him out. Go after him again.